Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to the class. In your abridged NEET chemistry material, we are solving the MCQs. Page number is 45, question number 14. The correct electronic configuration of PD. PD means palladium. P-A-L-L-A-D-I-U-M. Palladium. The correct electronic configuration of palladium 46 is. Here 46 indicating its atomic number. Atomic number. So the atomic number of palladium is given as 46. Yes, this is about the periodic table. In the next chapter, you will learn about the classification of elements. The elements are classified into four blocks. S block elements, P block elements, D block elements, and F block elements based on their electronic configurations. Once again, based on the electronic configurations, the elements are classified into four blocks. S block, P block, D block, and F block. If you say these groups, only these two groups, first group and second group, otherwise first A group and second A group, these are called as S block elements. And next, if you see from third B group, fourth B group, fifth B group, sixth B group, seventh B group, and eighth B group, or that is also called as zero group, these group elements are called as P block elements. Between the S block and P block, the elements present between the S and P block, these elements are called as D block elements. Here you can see D block elements, and of course they are also known as transition elements. In the coming chapters we will know what is meant by transition element, what is meant by D block element, and what is the difference between D block element to transition element. Everything will be learned in the next chapter, periodic classification of elements. And at the bottom of the S, D and F, P block elements, at the bottom of the S, D and P block elements, some more elements are given. These are called as F block elements. F block elements, they are also known as inner transition elements. So this is simple brief introduction about the classification of elements, and we want to know about palladium, PD. Yes, I'm going to zoom that one, palladium. Palladium. So for your convenient, I'm going to zoom it one. Yes, it is from your NCERT textbook. This is from your NCERT textbook. Here you can see PD. What is the atomic number of PD? Palladium, atomic number 46. So here, if you say the electronic configuration, here the written electronic configuration is 4D10. 4D10. Yes, coming to the board. So we have to write the electronic configuration for palladium, correct electronic configuration for palladium. So to write the electronic configuration of any element, we are following three principles: Hofbau principle, Pauli's exclusion principle, and Hund's rule. Yes. And we know the Mueller diagram. Mueller diagram is constructed on the basis of Hofbau principle. The Mueller diagram is constructed on the basis of Hofbau principle. Here I am writing the Mueller diagram. Yes, okay. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d. Next, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f. 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f. 6s, 6p, 6d. 7s, 7p, 8s. And we are going to arrange these orbitals in the increasing order of energies of orbitals by using n plus l values. By using n plus l values, we are going to arrange these in the increasing order of energies of orbitals. So then, already we studied that this is the filling of electrons in the increasing order of energies of orbitals. In the last classes, already we discussed this one. So then, we can write the orbitals in the increasing order of energies, that is 1s, next 2s, 2p, next 3s, 3p, next 4s, 3d, 4p, next 5s, 4d, 5p, next 6s, 4f, 5d, 6p. So after this one, it is enough to write the electronic configuration of 118 elements. Up to this one, it is enough. So once again, you have to remember 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p. Once again, 4s, 3d, 4p. Like that, 5s, 4d, 5p. But whereas in the case of 6s, 4f is included. 6s, 4f, 5d, 6p. Now, tell me the electronic configuration of palladium. Based on Arfbau principle, if you are going to write the electronic configuration of palladium, atomic number is given as 46. So first, I am going to take 1s, 2s, 2p. Here it is, 1s, 2s, 2p. Next it is 3s, 3p. 3s, 3p. Yes, after 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p. 4s, 3d, 4p. Next, after 4p, it is the 5s. 5s. Next, it is the 4d. Yes, we are going to fill 46 electrons. We have to fill 46 electrons in the given orbitals in the increasing order of energies. So first, we are going to fill 2 electrons. 1s2, next 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10, 4p6. Because we know s orbitals can have maximum of 2 electrons. P orbitals can have maximum of 6 electrons. D orbitals can have maximum of 10 electrons. F orbitals can have maximum of 14 electrons. Otherwise, the statement is S subshell can have maximum of 2 electrons. P subshell can have maximum of 6 electrons. D subshell can have maximum of 10 electrons. F subshell can have maximum of 14 electrons. Right? Now, count the electrons. We have to fill 46. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. 12 plus 6, 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 plus 10, 30. 36. So after this, how many electrons are completed? 36 electrons are completed. Next, 2 electrons. That means how many electrons are completed? 38 electrons are completed. So from 46, if we subtract 38, what is the remaining? What is the remaining? 8 is the remaining. That means we have to fill 8 more electrons. Where we have to fill the 8 more electrons? The 8 more electrons should be filled in 4D. 4D. Then we have to write the electronic configuration 48. So this is all according to which principle? This is according to which principle? This is the filling of electrons according to which principle? Arfbau principle. This is the filling of electrons according to Arfbau principle. But in the last class, we know that chromium and copper, the two elements, one is the chromium and second one is the copper, they are going to show abnormal electronic configuration. To expect the stability, these two elements are going to show abnormal electronic configuration. And these two elements are not obeying Arfbau principle. The chromium and copper, they are not obeying Arfbau principle. They are going to deviate to expect the stability. Like that, palladium is also going to disobey the Arfbau principle. So how it is going to disobey the Arfbau principle? Yes, actually we know the electronic configuration as what we know the electronic configuration. This is the final outermost shell electronic configuration. 5s2, 48. If I write 5s2, this is the completely filled orbital. Completely filled orbital. 48 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the filling of electrons according to which rule? According to Hund's rule. What the Hund's rule says, when the degenerated orbitals are available, all the degenerated orbitals are first filled with one electron, then only pairing is going to take place. So if we are following the Hund's rule, then we are writing the electronic configuration as 5s2, 48, right? But when these two electrons, 5s electrons, when the 5s electrons are going to jump to, when the 5s electrons are going to jump to 4d orbitals, 4d orbitals, what will be the expected, what will be the expected electronic configuration, what will be the expected electronic configuration? 5s becomes a zero because the two electrons from 5s is jumping into 4d, then 5s becomes a zero, 5s becomes zero, 4d becomes 10. See this one, 4d becomes 10 now. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Which type of orbital it is? Which type of orbital 5s? 5s is the empty orbital and 4d is the, 4d is the completely filled orbital. The 4d orbital is the completely filled orbital. All of us know empty orbitals containing atoms are more stable, as well as completely filled orbitals containing atoms are also more stable. Whereas in the case of 5s to 4d8, of course here completely filled orbitals are there, but here these orbitals are neither half filled, neither half filled nor completely filled. When 4d8 is taken, the 4d8 is indicating it is neither half filled nor completely filled. As a result, to expect the stability, the 5s electrons, 5s2 electrons, the two electrons of 5s, they are jumping into 4d, then 5s becomes a zero, 4d becomes 10. 5s0 is indicating it is the empty orbital, 4d10 is indicating it is the completely filled orbitals. Then the palladium is going to be more stable, the palladium is going to be more stable in which configuration? 5s0, 4d10 configuration. So finally, we can write the electronic configuration of palladium as, what is the electronic configuration of palladium? This is not the 5s2 48, it is not the 5s2 48. The electronic configuration of palladium is 5s0 4d10. Now tell me, in this electronic configuration, palladium is not going to obey which principle? If you write the electronic configuration like 5s0 4d10, which principle is not obeyed by palladium? It is the wrong answer. It is the wrong answer. Which principle is not obeyed by, yes, correct answer. Who's that one? Bhuneshwari, correct. Bhuneshwari and Bharat, correct. So 5s0 4d10, 5s. If you take the 5s, principal quantum number is 5. Azimuthal quantum number is 0. S orbital, azimuthal quantum number is 0. 5 is indicating principal quantum number. So total n plus l value, total n plus l value for 5s orbitals is 5. Whereas for 4d orbitals, for 4d orbitals, principal quantum number is equal to, the principal quantum number is equal to 4. Whereas azimuthal quantum number, small l, for the d orbitals, azimuthal quantum number is equal to 2. Now, n plus l value for 4d orbitals is 6. N plus l value for 5s orbitals is 5. Now tell me, among the 5s orbitals and 4d orbitals, which are lesser energetic orbitals? Among the 5s and 4d orbitals, which are lesser energetic orbitals? Yes, 5s orbitals are lesser energetic orbitals. Why? Because means 5s orbitals, n plus l value is 5. 4d orbitals, n plus l value is 6. 5 is lesser than 6. 5 is lesser than 6 means 5s orbitals are having lesser energy than 4d orbitals. According to Aufbau principle, always lower energy orbitals must be filled completely. Once again, according to the Aufbau principle, always lowest orbitals must be completely filled. But in the case of palladium, lower energy orbital is not filled. To expect the stability, the two electrons of 5s are jumping into 4d. As a result, palladium is not obeying Aufbau principle. Chromium and copper are not obeying Chromium and copper are not obeying Hof-Bau principle. What the Hof-Bau principle says? Whenever lower energy orbital and higher energy orbitals are there, electrons always first enters and completely fills in the lower energy orbitals, then only enters into higher energy orbitals. So that is about the complete concept. And for the given question, the complete correct electronic configuration of palladium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10, 4p6, 5s0, 5s0, 4d10. Yes, this is the important one. In the second POC, D block elements, the chapter name is D block elements, there will be also, it will be studied. Yes, for one mark level also, this type of questions are important for PU. Chromium and copper particularly. Yes. Next, we are moving to the topic. Next one. Electronic configurations. Next page. Question number 15. Read the question. The orbital configuration of chromium 24 is 3d5 4s1. The number of unpaired electrons in Cr3 plus. What is meant by Cr3 plus? Can anybody guess? What is meant by Cr3 plus? Means chromium is going to lose 3 electrons. Once again, chromium is going to lose 3 electrons. Actually, we know the chromium atomic number as 24. 24 electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d5. It is not the 4s2, 3d4. It is the 4s1, 3d5. And this is the outermost shell. In the outermost shell, 4s is having 1 electron. 3d is having 5 electrons. So total number of unpaired electrons present. Total number of unpaired electrons present in the chromium. How many number of unpaired electrons are present? In the chromium, how many number of unpaired electrons are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each single electron is called as an unpaired electron. So all these are the unpaired electrons. So chromium is having 6 unpaired electrons. Electronic configuration of chromium is 4s1, 3d5. Now, chromium is going to lose 3 electrons. When 3 electrons are lost, we can write the charge as 3 plus. When 3 electrons are lost, we are writing the charge as 3 plus. Electron is a negatively charged particle. Once again, the electron is a negatively charged particle. When 3 negatively charged particles are removed, then the spaces gets 3 positive charges. That is 3 plus. Chromium 3 plus. Now, tell me the electronic configuration. Now, you will get it out. 3 electrons are going to be removed. From which orbitals, the 3 electrons are going to be removed? Yes. Just a minute. Generally, we know that 1s, 2s2p, 3s3p, next 4s. So from where the first electron is going to be removed? Nucleus, first orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth orbit. 1s, 2s2p, 3s3p, and it is the 4s. 4s is called as, fourth shell is called as outermost shell. The fourth shell is called as outermost shell. Outermost shell is also known as valency shell. Valency shell is also known as nth shell. Outermost shell or valency shell or nth shell. Now, our question is, when chromium is going to lose 3 electrons, from where the electrons are going to be removed? First, from the fourth shell, the electron is going to be removed. The electronic configuration is 4s1. Now for S1 becomes, for S1 becomes for S0, for S0. Remaining two electrons are going to be removed from 3D orbitals. One electron is removed from 4s orbital. Remaining two electrons are removed from 3D orbitals. So 3D5 becomes as 3D5 becomes as 3D3. Yes, this is the orbital, vacant orbital, and 3D orbitals. How many electrons they are having? 1, 2, 3. Now tell me, chromium 3 plus is having how many number of unpaired electrons in its valency shell? Chromium 3 plus is having how many number of unpaired electrons in its valency shell? Yes, once again read the question. The number of unpaired electrons present in Cr 3 plus is, so these are the number of unpaired electrons, nothing but 3 unpaired electrons are present. 3 unpaired electrons are present in Cr 3 plus. Yes, the next question, question number 16. Read the question. Question number 16. Yes, my dear student, this is the important one. Chromium 3 plus. Chromium 3 plus. This type of models are important for CET and NEET. Chromium 3 plus, this type of species and their electronic configurations and their valency shell configurations and their number of unpaired electrons in their valency shells. These type of questions are important for CET and NEET. Now, question number 16. When 3D orbitals are completely filled, question number 16, right? When 3D orbitals are completely filled, when the 3D orbitals are completely filled, the new electron will enters into, the new electron will enters into, the new electron will enters into, just now we written the increasing order of energies of orbitals as 1s, 2s, 2p, next 3s, 3p, next 4s, 3d, 4p. Yes, this is the filling of electrons. This is the filling of electrons. 4s, 3d, 4p, 5s, 4d, 5p. So after 3d, the electrons enters into, after 3d, the electrons enters into 5s, 5s. Just a minute, ma. What he is asking? When 3d orbitals are completely filled, the new electrons will enters into after 3d. Yes, just a minute, just a minute. We have to check the n plus l value. Let's check here. If we take 4p orbitals and 5s orbitals. For 4p orbitals, n value is equal to 4, l value is equal to 1. For the p orbitals, azimuthal quantum number value is 1. So n plus l value for 4p orbital is 5. N plus l value for 5s orbitals, n value is 5, l value. For the s orbitals, l value is equal to 0, total value 5. So in the case of 4p orbitals and 5s orbitals, both are having same n plus l values. Both are having same n plus l values. In this case, we have to consider lesser n value. Lesser n value. So among the 4p orbital and 5s orbital, which one is having the lesser n value? Among the 4p orbital and 5s orbital, which one is having the lesser n value? Yes, correct. So which orbital after 3d, after 3d, the electrons enters into 4p orbitals. 4p orbitals. This is according to which principle? This is according to which principle? This is according to Hof-Bau principle or n plus l rule, right? Yes, next question. Question number 17. Question number 17. When 3p orbitals are completely filled, then newly entering electrons goes to question number 17. Read it and answer it. Question number 17. When 3p orbitals are completely filled, the newly entering electrons goes to, yes, correct answer, 4s orbitals. Okay, now question number 18. See the question number 18. How many electrons in K19? K means, what is meant by K? K means potassium. Potassium, that is the atom or the element potassium. Of course, Kannada, you are using Kannada, Bharat. No need of Kannada, it is not Kannada medium, Bharat. It is English medium only. Don't use Kannada script. Okay, fine. Once again, the question number 18. How many electrons in K19, potassium 19, have N is equal to 3, principal quantum number. N means, small n means principal quantum number is equal to 3, azimuthal quantum number is equal to 0. Yes, principal quantum number 3 means top shell, azimuthal quantum number 0 means S orbital or S subshell. So this is the 3s orbital. N value 3, L value 0 is indicating it is the 3s orbital. S orbital means it is the only one orbital. One orbital can have maximum of 2 electrons. So potassium 19, which is going to have the principal quantum number 3, azimuthal quantum number 0, that is going to have how many electrons? 2 electrons. Why? Because means the given quantum numbers are indicating it is the 3s orbital. An orbital can have maximum of 2 electrons only. So that is the answer, 2 electrons. Is that an option? Okay, question number 18, option B. This type of models are also important for KSET and NEET. Yes, question number 19. The maximum number of 3D electrons having spin quantum number S is equal to plus of. The maximum number of electrons of 3D. The maximum number of 3D electrons having spin quantum number S is equal to plus of 3D orbital. 3D orbital. This is the 3D subshell. 3D subshell is having 5 orbitals. DXY orbital, DYZ orbital, DXZ orbital, DX square Y square orbital, and DZ square orbital. D subshell. D subshell can have maximum of 10 electrons. 5 electrons with spin. Clockwise spin. Clockwise spin means spin quantum number value plus of. 5 electrons with anti-clockwise spin. Anti-clockwise spin is also called as counter-clockwise spin. Spin quantum number is equal to minus of. Here, we have to say the spin quantum number with plus of. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a completely filling of electrons in the 3D orbitals. Yes. Now the question is, the maximum number of 3D electrons having spin quantum number S is equal to plus of. How many electrons are having with S is equal to plus of? Yes, correct answer. 5 electrons are having. This is the electron 1. This is the electron 2. This is the electron 3. This is the electron 4. This is the electron 5. So these 5 electrons are having clockwise orientation. As a result, their spin quantum numbers are going to be plus of. Next, question number 20. Text me the answer. For question number 20, text me your answer. Yes, text me your answer for question number 20. Yes, C is the answer. Correct. Next, question number 21. Okay, fine. Question number 21. In which of the following, all the electrons are paired? In which of the following, all the electrons are paired? Yes. If you say the option B, second option B, nitride nitride ion is given. All of you know the word oxide. Oxide. Can you say the formula of oxide? What is the formula of oxide ion? In the lower classes, 9th class, 10th class, you studied about, you heard about oxide, oxides. What is the formula? It is not O minus. Bharat, it is not O minus. O2 minus, correct. Yoga Venkata Prasad, correct. Yoga Venkata Prasad, Uraf Vaibhav. Very good answer. Yes, once again, oxide. Oxide ion means, what is the formula? What is the symbol? O2 minus is called as oxide ion. Like that, nitride ion means, what is the meaning of nitride ion? N3 minus ion. N means nitrogen. 3 minus. Nitrogen atom is going to gain 3 electrons. Nitrogen atom. What is the atomic number of nitrogen atom? The atomic number of nitrogen atom is 7. It is going to gain 3 more electrons. Now total number of electrons are 10. Now we can write the symbol as N3 minus. Atomic number of nitrogen is 7. So nitrogen atom itself contains 7 electrons. It is gaining 3 more electrons. So we have to write plus 3. 7 electrons plus 3 electrons, total number of electrons are 10. So nitride ion is having 10 electrons. And one more thing, all of you know the neon. Neon. What is the atomic number of neon? What is the atomic number of neon? Yes, the atomic number of neon is 10. Neon is also containing how many electrons? Neon is also containing 10 electrons. Now, what we can say about nitride ion and neon? What we can say about nitride ion and neon? What we can say about nitride ion and neon? Correct answer, Yoga Venkata Prasad again. Neon and nitride ion are. Neon and nitride ion are isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species. What is meant by isoelectronic? Having same number of electrons. Once again, what is meant by isoelectronic? Having same number of electrons is called as isoelectronic. Okay, fine. So remember the formula, important one, nitride ion. The formula is, or the symbol is N3 minus. N3 minus. Nitride ion is an example of. Nitride ion is an example of. Nitride ion is an example of. Anion. Anion. What is meant by anion? Any atom, when it is going to gain the electrons, any atom, when it is going to gain the electrons, it becomes a negative ion. The negatively charged ions, the negatively charged ions are called as anions. Once again, the negatively charged ions are called as anions. The positively charged ions are called as cations. The positively charged ions are called as cations. The negatively charged ions are called as anions. Atom means that is neutral. It is neither having positive charge nor having negative charge. Then that is generally neutral. Atoms are neutral. Right. Next, question number 22. Question number 22. That is based on a CBSE model. CBSE model, that is the one. Question number 22. Generally in our NCERT or in our PU board, this type of symbols will not be given. Question number 22. Let's read the question. In an atom which has 2K, 8L, 8M and 2N electrons in the ground state, the total number of electrons having small l is equal to 1 or, yes, you will get a doubt. Sir, why you are not coming onto the board? Somebody is getting the doubt. Why sir is not coming onto the board? Why? Because means sometimes it is having zoom in, zoom out problem. Actually, there is no need of my presence on board here. When I am writing, I am here. When I am going to explain, I am here. So don't wait for my presence. Just listen my words. Once again, the question number 22. In an atom which has 2K, 8L, 8M and 2N electrons in the ground state, the total number of electrons having L value, small L value is equal to 1. Yes, 2K, 8L, 8M and 2N. What is meant by KLMN? What is meant by KLMN? According to Niels Bohr's model of atom, K indicating, K is indicating first shell, L is indicating second shell or orbit. Shell is nothing but orbit, first orbit, second orbit, or first shell and second shell. M is indicating third orbit or third shell. Capital N is indicating fourth orbit or fourth shell. Now, 2K means two electrons are present in first orbit. First orbit contains S subshell. So 2K means 1s2. 2K means 1s2. L means second shell. Second shell contain S subshell and P subshell. Once again, the second shell is going to contain S subshell and P subshell. 8L is given. 8L means 8 electrons are present in second shell. How can we write 8 electrons? 2 electrons in S subshell, 6 electrons in P subshell. So 8L is indicating 2s2, 2p6. Next, 8m. M indicates third shell. Third shell contain S subshell and P subshell. We have to fill 8 electrons. 2 electrons in S subshell, 6 electrons in P subshell. And next one, 2N. N indicates fourth shell. We are going to take 4 S orbitals. How many electrons are there? 2 electrons are there. That is the 2N. 2N is indicating 4S2. So 2K, 8L, 8M and 2N, the electronic configuration is represented as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. Now, we are going to the question. So I am writing the electronic configuration, rearranging the electronic configuration, rearrangement as S orbitals and P orbitals, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, right? 3s2, 3p6 and 4s2. Yes, the question asked is small l is equal to 1. Small l is equal to 1 indicate width subshell. Small l is equal to 1 indicate width subshell, P subshell. Yes, see here. Here is a P subshell is present. So how many electrons are there with L value 1? How many electrons are there with small L value is equal to 1? How many total number of electrons are there with small L value is equal to 1? On the board, the answer is there. Check one. Please check once. Small L value. What is meant by small L value? P subshell. See this one? 2P subshell is there. 2P subshell is there. How many electrons are there? 6 electrons are there. P subshell means small L value is equal to 1. How many electrons are there? 6 electrons are there here in 2P subshell and in 3P subshell. This is a 3P subshell having 6 electrons. P subshell means again L value is equal to 1. So small L value is equal to 1 containing electrons. How many total electrons are there? 6 electrons are there in 2P subshell. 6 electrons are there in 3P subshell. So total number of electrons is equal to 12. It is not the 6. The answer is 12. Is it understand? Is there any doubt regarding this question? Right. So you have to read the question properly and you have to understand the properly. So without understanding properly, you will get the wrong answer. So please take some time to read the question. Please take some time to read the question. Please take some time to understand the question. Then you will get the answer correctly. So don't get confused, please. Very, very important topic. This is the topic. 2K, ATL, ATM, 2N electrons in the ground state. The total number of electrons having small L value is equal to 1. What is the answer? 12. Now my question is, one more question. For the same question, how many number of electrons? How many number of electrons are there with S is equal to 0? Yes, text me your answer. How many number of electrons are there with S is equal to 0? What is meant by S is equal to 0? First of all, tell me, what is meant by... Sorry, my dear students. Please wait. Yes, sorry. Once again, the question. How many number of electrons are there with L is equal to 0? L is equal to 0 means S sub shell. L is equal to 0 means S sub shell. See the S sub shells? Here S sub shell is there. That is 1s2. Here S sub shell is there. That is 2s2. Here S sub shell is there. That is 3s2. So L is equal to 0 is indicating S sub shell. In this electronic configuration, we are having 1s sub shell, 2s sub shell, 3s sub shell. So L is equal to 0 containing electrons. Small L is equal to 0 containing electrons. How many are there? Why again you are saying 8? Sai Krishna, why you are saying again 8? Don't you know the mathematics? I am saying very clearly, L is equal to 0 indicating S sub shell. In this electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. Yes, very good. Sorry, Sai Krishna. Yes, here we have to consider 4s2. I forgot on that one. Sorry, Sai Krishna. Yes, correct answer. 4s2 is also there. Now, 2 electrons are in 1s, 2 electrons are in 2s, 2 electrons are in 3s, 2 electrons are in 4s. So, total number of electrons with L is equal to 0 are 8. Yes, Sai Krishna is the correct answer. Yes, just a minute. I had to take the attendance first. Yes, read the next question. Read the next question, please. If you know the answer, please text me the answer. Otherwise, we will discuss. And today, I'm going to send two videos. One is the recorded video, morning's recorded video, and second one is this class video. So today, I'm going to send two videos. Yes, Yoga Venkata Prasad, once again, text me. What is your texting? I'm not observed. Yoga Venkata Prasad. Sorry, sir. I didn't see that 3S2, sir. Correct. Yoga Venkata Prasad. Actually, students should follow the teacher. But blindly, I am following you. Because you are very sharp, very intelligent. That's why blindly I am following you. That's why I made a mistake in this class. Anyhow, thank you. Thank you for all your response. You are doing very well. Very good. Yes. See the next question. Question number 23. Read the question number 23. Let's read the question. Very, very important one. That is also copper, chromium and copper. If anywhere chromium and copper is given, those questions are very, very important one. Question number 23. Electrons of copper 29. See here, 29. Where the 29 is given? The 29 is given in the subscript part. If any number is written at the bottom, that part is called as subscript part. The number whatever given in the subscript path that indicates the number given in the subscript path indicates atomic number. So right, very good, correct. Atomic number is indicated by Z. So atomic number of copper is given, 29 is given. How many number of electrons are present here? 29 electrons are present. In the last video, we discussed about abnormality of chromium and copper in their electronic configurations. So according to abnormality, the electronic configuration of copper is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Yes, tell me now, what is the next one? What is the next continuation configuration? What is the continuation configuration of copper? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Next one. 4s1, 3d10. According to Aufbau principle, we have to write 4s2, 3d9. If we follow the Aufbau principle, we have to write the electronic configuration as 4s2, 3d9. But when the electron is jumping from 4s2 3d, 4s2 becomes 4s1, 3d9 becomes 3d10. So this is the correct electronic configuration of copper, and copper is not obeying Aufbau principle. So finally, we can say that the electronic configuration of copper is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d10. Yes, what is the question asked? The valency electrons of copper lies in the which shell? Let's say this one. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d. This is the first shell. This is the second shell. This is the third shell. And this is the fourth shell. First shell is called as K shell. Second shell is called as L shell. Third shell is called as M shell. Fourth shell is called as N shell. And according to the electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d10. 4s1, 3d10. Now tell me, which one is the last shell? The last shell is called as outermost shell. Outermost shell. Which one is the outermost shell? Nth shell. Capital N here. Fourth shell is the outermost shell. So the outermost shell electrons are called as valency electrons. So copper is containing how many number of valency electrons? Text me the answer. Copper is containing how many number of valency electrons? Yes, correct answer. One electron. Generally, if you check the electronic configuration, just see here, if you write the electronic configuration of copper, we are writing the copper electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d10. Generally, we are writing like this. According to stability of the atom, 4s1, 3d10. Now, we expect that these electrons are going to be the valency electrons. We expect that 3d10 electrons are going to be the valency electrons. But 3d10 electrons are not the valency electrons, because first shell, then second shell, then third shell, then it is the fourth shell. This is the first shell electrons. These are the second shell electrons. These are the third shell electrons. These are also the third shell electrons. So what are the fourth shell electrons? What are the outermost shell electrons? The outermost shell electrons are also called as valency shell electrons. So copper is containing how many number of valency shell electrons? One electron. What is the valency shell of copper? What is the valency shell of copper? Capital Nth shell. Capital Nth shell is the valency shell of copper. Yes, it is an important question. Next question is Question number 24. Read the question and try to answer it. Question number 24. Read it and answer it. Question number 24. Yes, text me your answer. Two, sir. Question number 24. Text me the option, please. Text me your option, not the answer. Text me the option. A, B, C, D is given. What is the option? Yes, correct option. D is the correct option. Right. Yes, okay. Next question number 25. Read the question number 25. Read the question number 25. Please read the question number 25. Question number 25, please. For that one also D. Wow, super. Correct answer. Correct answer. So, okay. Fine. Okay. Next question number 26. See the question number 26. For the question number 26. Yes, the question is, the penultimate shell of francium. The penultimate shell of francium. What is the atomic number of francium? Z is given as 87. Z is given as 87. Francium, the atomic number is given as 87. Yes, on the screen. On the screen, once again, I'm going to share you the periodic table. Just give me a minute. I'm going to rearrange it to make you convenient. Yes, on the screen you can see the periodic table. S block elements. S block elements. What are the S block elements? First group elements. That is the first A group elements. And second group elements. That are the second A group elements. So both first group elements and second group elements, they are the S block elements. So here it is the francium. My dear students, of course I think so, the time is completed. But still, the Zoom session is going on. I don't know why. Anyhow, next class is there for you. That's why I'm going to stop the session here. Please consider me. We'll discuss this topic in the next class because your time is precious to me also. So here you can see the francium symbol, FR. FR means francium. That is the first A group element or the S block element. So about this one, in the next class, we will discuss. Thank you, one and all. Yes, text me your response about the class. Do you understand the class? Do you understand the class? Yes. About this question, if you understood, please text me your answer to my WhatsApp number. About the question number 26, if you understood, please text me your response to my WhatsApp number. Thank you, Nadal. In the next class, we will discuss. Thank you. Have a nice day.